Welcome. So the magnetic field on an axial line of a bar magnet, that we are going to find out. So what we have to do, we have to consider a bar magnet. So this is the north pole and this is the south pole. Okay. Let us consider small m is the pole strength of this bar magnet. Pole strength is equal to m. That means the north pole having the pole strength m and the south pole also having the pole strength m. Let us consider the magnetic length, that is the difference between the two poles, is 2L. So if I consider that O is the midpoint of that bar magnet, then from N to O can be considered as L, and from O to S also can be considered as L. Now, if I consider a point on which I want to determine the magnetic field, that is at the point P, which is at a distance small r from the midpoint of it. And also here we consider that here is a pole, a isolated pole of pole strength 1 is kept here. Okay, and that is an north. So, if it is a north, isolated north pole is placed of pole strength 1. This is a north pole of pole strength m, this is a south pole of pole strength m, but it is a test pole, so testing north pole, so it is a pole strength 1. So what is the magnetic field at the point P that we have to determine? So I consider this is the point A and this is the point B. So magnetic field on P, magnetic field on P due to the north pole which is placed at the point A is BPA. So that is M divided by the separation between them is up to here is R and it is R plus L. So I can say R plus L whole square. Here is mu naught divided by 4 pi. In which direction? The magnetic field is in which directions? This isolated north pole of strength 1 try to move in that particular direction. So I can say this is the direction of BPA. So this is from A to P. So I can write down it is along A to P. Similarly, if I try to find out what is the magnetic field at the point P due to the south pole which is placed at the point B, so it is this notations I will going to use. So this will be mu naught divided by 4 pi. Since the pole strength is same, so I am writing down m here, pole strength of the south pole, and what is the distance between them? From here to here it is r. So obviously L is reduced, so it will be from here to here, that is from B to P will be R minus L. So this will be R minus L whole square along the south pole will be attracted towards this south pole will attract this north pole, or the north pole of unit strength will be attracted towards it. So we can say this is the direction of the magnetic field at the point P due to the south pole placed at the point B. So this is along PB. So these two vectors BP and BPB are opposite directions. Their directions are different and their magnitudes are also different. Okay. So BP and BPB, their magnitudes are different, their directions are also different. So if I want to find out the magnetic field at the point P, then which one is greater, that we have to find it out. BPB is greater because here is R minus L whole square. BPA is less because here is R plus L whole square in denominator. Since it is a less number, so BPB is greater. Since it is a greater number, so obviously BPA is less. So the resultant magnetic field will be along the directions of the BPB. that is along PB. So I am here just subtracting the magnitude of BPB minus BPA, BPB minus BPA, subtracting BPA from BPB. Along which directions? Along directions of the BPB, that is along PB vector. So if I just put the values, then it will be mu naught divided by 4 pi small m r minus l whole square minus mu naught divided by 4 pi m divided by r plus l whole square along p b. So if mu naught small m divided by 4 pi is taken common from here, then it will be 1 divided by r minus l whole square minus of r plus l whole square along PB. So after that I am writing here, that is mu naught divided by 4 pi pole strength. So if I do the LCM, that will be r minus l whole square into r plus l whole square. So I can simply write down r plus l into r minus l whole square. So it will be r plus l whole square into r minus l whole square, and that is along PB. That is along PB. So mu naught divided by 4 pi m, it is a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square, that means 4ab, that is 4rl, divided by r plus l into r minus l, that is a plus b into a minus b, becomes r square minus l square whole square along p b. So this will become mu naught m divided by 4 pi. So I am just writing down this 12 here. I am just writing down this 12 here and 2 here, just like 4 r l. I am just separated as 12 into 2 r, r square minus of l square whole square along PB. Now just think, if I try to write down what is the magnetic moment of this magnet, then it will be m vector equal to pole strength, magnetic length, and from south to north, that is the direction of the PB. From south to north is basically the direction of PB. So I can simply just place M vector here. So it will become mu naught capital M vector divided by 4 pi r square minus of L square whole square, and here is 2 r, along PB. I need not to write because I have placed M vector here, so I am just removing this. So after that it will be 2 mu naught M r divided by 4 pi r square minus L square whole square. Now if I try to just do an approximation, that the magnetic length is very less compared to that of this r, then what we can say, if r is very greater than 12, if r is very greater than 12, then I can simply write down this r square minus l square as r square. So this will become, that is the magnetic field at the point P will become mu naught 2 mu naught M vector divided by 4 pi r to the power 4, and here is r. So this thing cancels out, it becomes r cube. So it becomes mu naught M vector divided by 2 pi r cube. So this is the thing. That is the expression after approximation by considering the pole length, sorry, the magnetic length, that is the length of the magnet is very small compared to that of the distance, then this is the expression, or otherwise this will be the expression of the magnetic field at the point P. Thank you.